مسلم قرآن اسمك I hear the calling of them With it we unite We are special only If we follow his light The way of Muhammad Calling to paradise Ya Allah, Ya Allah We are your servants, Ya Allah La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim Brothers, sisters and viewers around the world Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh And welcome to another episode of the Servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala My name is Hisham Bella and I'm your host We're going through qualities that really define those individuals who are called the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who are they? And what are their qualities? And one of their beautiful attributes is that they follow the Qur'an and Sunnah. Yes, and that's the topic that we will be going through in the next two episodes, inshallah, with our Shaykh and teacher and our Imam, Shaykh Saeed Al-Gadi. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Shaykh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Sayyidi Shaykh. Barakallahu fiqh.
Barakallahu fiqh. Jazakallahu khairan for your time.
Ameen, inshallah.
Shaykh, as we know, following the Qur'an and Sunnah are the fundamentals of our deen. One may say it's quite clear that we have to follow the Qur'an and Sunnah. But really the main aim of this episode is to really delve deeply into this and really understand and look at the sayings of the scholars and some of the direct sayings of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam concerning the issue of following the Qur'an and Sunnah and what it means, what it implies, and how will we, by following the Qur'an and Sunnah, gain the love of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and become amongst those who are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beloved. So first of all, please tell us, Shaykh, what does following the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's Sunnah, what does it imply?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'een, all praise due to Allah alone. We praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. Repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. Following the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam means that we obey Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in all of His orders. And we believe him in whatever he said to us. We believe him in whatever he told us about. And we stay away from that which he forbidden upon us. So this is in summary what does it mean to follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That was quite a summarized answer. But inshallah ta'ala we'll open these things up a bit further inshallah ta'ala and really try and look deeply inside them, bi-idhnillah. But first of all, before we do that, the question that we always ask ourselves in this show, the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is how will following the sunnah bring about the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, in a very clear verse, he mentioned that if we want really to gain his love, then the access to gain his love and the way to gain his love and the method to gain his love is that when you follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said in the Quran in Surah Al Imran,
قُلْ إِن كُنتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي O Muhammad, tell them that if you truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then follow me. فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ So follow me, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, will love you. And furthermore, will forgive your sins.
Subhanallah.
So therefore, it is a clear verse that whenever we follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love us, and He will forgive all of our sins, inshallah.
Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakallahu khairan for that. Yeah, that's really nice news to hear, mashallah.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar. This is so beautiful. Shaykh, also, what are the virtues of following the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?
I can summarize all the virtues, Hisham, that the people who will follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will be rightly guided. Guidance can be sought from following the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam.
Allah ta'ala in the Quran said,
وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا.
If you want guidance, then follow his sunnah. Obey him and he will gain guidance. You want guidance, then obey him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Obey the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to gain guidance. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. And then also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the sound hadith, which Al-Irbad ibn Sari, one of the companions, narrated, said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or Al-Irbad said, may Allah be pleased with him. Al-Irbad said that the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one day, he gave us an admonition, which made our hearts be fearful. An admonition that made our hearts fearful. And our eyes tearful. And we said, Ya Rasulullah, as if this a farewell sermon. So Rasulullah give us an advice. He sallam, said,
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
Alaykum bi taqwa Allah.
Subhanallah.
Have piety and gain piety and be fearful of Allah and be mindful of Allah. And then he said, وَعَلَيْكُمْ بِالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَةِ. And be listening and be obedient. Even if a slave man was appointed as a leader upon you. So listen and obey. And then he said, for the ones amongst you who will live for a long time, those who will live a long life, they will see many differences. So what we should do? فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي. Then he said, if you see these differences, then stick. Hold on to my sunnah. Observe my sunnah. Stick to my sunnah. And the sunnah of my rightly guided successors. Rightly guided successors. The Sahaba, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali. And then he says, فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ. Or he said, عُضُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّمَاجِذِ, meaning that stick to the sunnah of mine and the sunnah of the rightly guided successors, and hold on to them with your molar teeth. Mean don't leave them at all. Don't go an inch beyond them. And then he gave us another guideline. He said, and don't introduce any new matter to the deen. Don't bring any innovation. The deen is full. The deen is complete. The deen is perfect. So don't bring anything new to the deen. For anything which is new, for any innovation in the deen, indeed is an error or misguidance. And that misguidance will lead to the hellfire.
Subhanallah. May Allah save us from that.
It is a comprehensive advice that shows that guidance can be attained and obtained if you follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So therefore, if you want Allah's love, we want to be guided in this life, rightly guided in this life, then we have to love, we have to follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we see here that the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the servants of Allah, those who follow his sunnah, one of the virtues of them following his sunnah is that they will be guided. And this is another quality, is that the guided ones. Subhanallah. This deserves another episode.
They will be beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will be rightly guided. Allah akbar.
Subhanallah, the guided ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to his sunnah.
Ameen, ameen. Sheikh, can it's a question to it is an advice to anybody who wants guidance and who is confused and who says, I would like Allah to guide me and I cannot stop drinking. I want Allah to guide me and I cannot stop smoking. I want Allah to guide me and I cannot pray.
Well, the way to guidance is you have to seek guidance. Seek guidance. How to seek guidance? Stop from the from all that which is haram. And also, follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to you, do not drink, do not drink. So you do not eat that which is haram, do not do that which is haram. He gave you a prescription of your clothes, then you do the same thing that he do it upon you, upon his prescription. So then, follow his guidance. Follow his guidance, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to gain huda, to gain guidance.
Hidayah. Sheikh, what can you give us a definition of what is a sunnah? What is constituted as a sunnah?
The sunnah is whatever the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said or did or approved. So we have three things. Either he did it, or either he said it, or he did it, or approved it. And in the three occasions, the three cases, he did them for the sake of worship. So say something for sake of worship. And his intention was to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or did something and his intention was to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or approved something and his intention was to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakallahu khairan. Sheikh, what are the different types of sunnah?
I just covered them, which is the qawliya and fi'liya, which is the what he said and what he did, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and what he has approved. These are the types of sunnah.
Subhanallah. So can we define a sunnah into different types, like sunnah mu'akkada and sunnah which is not obligatory and other things? So can we these descriptions, what kind of connotations do they carry?
Well, sunnah mu'akkad means sunnah that is more recommended. Mm-hmm. But at the end, sunnah. Sunnah is the, you talk about the sunnah in good deeds. The sunnah in the good deeds means that the sunnah, the action that whoever does it will be rewarded, and whoever leaves it won't be punished.
Mm-hmm.
This is sunnah. Okay, a sunnah is any action that whoever does it will be rewarded, and whoever leaves it won't be punished. We call it sunnah. Okay, but what we're talking about now, we're talking about the sunnah, the way of life of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should follow his way of life. We should follow all of his guidelines and all of his commands and all of his instructions. We should follow the way of his life, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Jazakallahu khairan, Shaykh. We're going to take a break now, inshallah, and we'll get straight back to this topic. Brothers and sisters, we'll see you straight after this break. Barakallahu feekum.
La ilaha illallah Muhammadu Rasulullah.
And get to know, we will discuss a wide variety of topics, including sports, friendship, toys, and much more. In this program, we have a segment called Make It Yourself, in which we will learn how to make simple items using very interesting things. If you are between the ages of 7 and 14, and want to learn how to make very useful things and have fun at the same time, well then, this is the program for you. Join us here on Huda TV.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome, brothers and sisters. Before the break, we were discussing the issue of the sunnah. And what does it mean to follow the sunnah? And what does it imply when we say we must follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And Sheikh, you mentioned before the break that We must, when we say the Sunnah, we mean the complete way of life of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We find many individuals concentrating specifically on, for example, when we mention the Sunnah, we mean the, a lot of people think about the apparent Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So keeping the beard and having a thobe and all other appearances of the Sunnah. And they may not concentrate on the other parts of the Sunnah, like the behaviors and the etiquettes of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the actions of the heart, which the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did. Can you shed some light on this? Can you advise us on this issue, please?
Jazakallah khair, may Allah bless you. Well, you mentioned many things that need to be clarified to the viewers. When we say the Sunnah, and then we give some examples like the beard and so on and so forth, then we mean here that the Sunnah, which is the way of life of the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, which implies many things which are obligatory and many things which are Sunnah. Okay? So for example, leaving the beard is obligatory.
Yes.
And at the same time is Sunnah. Does that make sense?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
And so you get the reward for following the obligatory action and for following the Sunnah of the Prophet.
Exactly, exactly.
Jazakallah khair.
When it comes to the classifying the actions that we do, okay, then we classify the action into obligatory, Sunnah, and forbidden. Obligatory, Sunnah, and forbidden. Obligatory, which if we leave it, we got to be punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we do it, we got to be rewarded. Sunnah is we leave it, we will be, won't be punished, mm-hmm. and if you do it, you're going to be rewarded. And the yes. haram, of course, if you do it, you're going to be punished, and if you leave, you're going to be rewarded. So, therefore, we have to understand the term sunnah, in which context we say it, in which context we are using it. If you are using it to in the context of distinguishing between the which action we're going to be rewarded, which action we're going to be punished for, then the sunnah is these actions which are not obligatory upon us. But when we speak about the sunnah in general, we mean the sunnah, the way of life of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And all sometimes we mean the sunnah when we say, what are we following? We're following the way of life of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also following the sunnah, his statements, what he said, and what yes. he did, and what he has approved.
So would that mean that everything that the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did is a sunnah?
Not really.
Well, some of his actions, habits, or culture or tradition or other things.
Yes, Imam Shatibi rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned this matter, and he said that whatever. Let me give you, make it just easy, simple, okay? Yes. Whatever he Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did for the sake of ibadah, for the sake of worship, whatever action he did صلى الله عليه وسلم to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it is a sunnah, and we should have the same intention of him to do this action, and we want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, he صلى الله عليه وسلم let's say that he used to leave his beard, okay? It's obligation, and he left it. He didn't touch the beard, okay? So this is a sunnah, and we know that it's wajib as well. Okay? He did this, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he did it for as an act of worship. So we follow him, and we do that as an act of worship.
Yes.
Okay? If he did something else, and his intention was not to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we don't have the right to do the action and have the intention to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Whatever he did and his intention was to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we don't have the right to have an intention to the action, to do the action and worship Allah ta'ala through the action.
But can we have an intention to follow his sunnah?
We have an intention to follow his sunnah.
Follow our Prophet.
To follow him and imitate him, okay, so that we might be rewarded for this. I'll give you an example. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to wear a thawb. Okay? But he never said that thawb is sunnah or more rewarding. So we want to wear thawb like him,
sallallahu alayhi
wa sallam. Or he used to leave his top button open because it was hot at the time. Can you say this is sunnah? We can't say sunnah.
No, you can say it was done out of necessity.
Exactly. He did it out of his personal choice.
Yeah, he didn't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through.
This is the bottom line. Mm-hmm. If he did any action to worship Allah through, then we call it sunnah, and if we do it, we're going to be rewarded. And we should have intention to do it as an act of worship. Another example. He used to prolong his hair. Sallallahu and many of the companions do the same thing. Can you call this sunnah?
It's a sunnah in terms of that the Prophet did it, mm-hmm. but is it a wajib? I wouldn't think so.
Hold on. The question will be here: has he done it to worship Allah Ta'ala or not?
Yes.
No, he hasn't.
Of course not. Yes.
No. Okay. So he didn't do it to worship Allah Ta'ala. That's why, if it was more rewarding, he wouldn't say to one of the companions when he asked him about his hair, he said to him, you either shave it all or leave it all.
Yes.
Okay? So if it was sunnah, he would have said to him, okay, or if it was more rewarding, he would have said to him, leave your hair. Another example I'll give you. Okay? He sallam shaved his hair. So he did that, isn't it?
Yes.
And he prolonged his hair.
Yes.
Which one is sunnah now? Okay?
Well, so now we find that the Prophet Muhammad sallam, I think from the rahmah of Allah Ta'ala, we could say that Allah allowed him to, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him that leeway to do so much that maybe we can gain the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from, or we can gain the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the love of Allah ta'ala through just following these things which were not acts of worship at all.
When we follow them, just imitate him.
Yes.
But we don't confuse them with the acts of worship. Now, listen, some people, they may prolong their hair and say, okay, this is sunnah, and you have to do this and this. This is the mistake that we have. People, they wear thobe and say, this is sunnah, we have to wear thobe. This is the mistake that we have. Okay, it's better that we separate between what he did out of worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what he did as out of his humanity and his nature, and what happened to him, what he did randomly, what he did as custom. Many things that he sallam was out of custom.
Subhanallah.
I'll give you an example. He sallam used to in one occasion, one of his trips, he passed by a tree, and he slept under a tree between Mecca and Medina. Okay? So is it a sunnah to sleep under that tree? Sunnah.
No, of course not.
No, because did he do it out of worship?
No, I wouldn't think so. He done it out of necessity.
No, he did it intentionally, first of all. He didn't do it worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He just, it was like accidentally. Yeah?
It was a necessary thing.
He felt necessary thing to sleep and to have some rest. One of the companions used to follow him in everything, even in this issue. Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu anhu.
Radiallahu
one of the great companions. And by the way, Abdullah ibn Umar is one of the people who used to trim the hair after the qabba, after the, we call it the...
One handful, one fistful.
Fistful, la miwa. So, they said Abdullah ibn Umar would not do that unless if he saw him. And this is the Albani opinion, rahimahullah. Let's go back to the topic. Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu anhu, used to follow him in everything. And he, radiallahu anhu, may be pleased with him, used to sleep under that tree, which Rasulullah slept under, in the way from between Medina and Mecca. And when his father heard about this, Umar radiallahu anhu, he got upset. Told him, this is what will destroy people and lead them astray. This is not sunnah. And then he ordered for that tree to be chopped out. Yes.
Subhanallah.
You see, because this is not, it's not from the, he did Rasulullah out of worship. And if I give you some example, do you have much time or how long do you have?
No, we only have a minute left.
InshaAllah ta'ala, afterwards I'll talk about that. InshaAllah ta'ala.
InshaAllah ta'ala. Barakallahu feek, Shaykh. Jazakallahu khairan for your time. InshaAllah ta'ala, we're running out of time now, but InshaAllah ta'ala, we'll go back to this topic and really try and open up this matter a bit more, InshaAllah ta'ala. Jazakallahu khairan for your time, Shaykh. Barakallahu feek. Brothers and sisters, Jazakumullah for tuning in. InshaAllah ta'ala, in the next episode, we'll be, inshallah ta'ala, opening up this topic even further, bi-idhnillah. I've been your host, Hisham Bella, and this has been your show, The Servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I am a Muslim, Quran is my guide. I hear the call.
special only if we follow his light, the way of Muhammad, calling to paradise. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, we are your servants, Ya Allah. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah.